Hello, this is Dr. Carlo Oger, emergency physician, and in this education video, we're going to talk about packers and stuffers, contraband in the ED. This video slide was based on an article published on Emergency Medicine Physicians Monthly. Body stuffers is the term used to describe individuals who rapidly swallow illegal contraband such as cocaine or heroin in an attempt to avoid prosecution when confronted by the police or authorities. Body packers swallow or pack a selected body orifice with drugs in an attempt to conceal and illegally transport paraphernalia across international borders. Body packing uses more methodological means of packing such as multi-layered latex, rubber, or condoms to prevent the packets from rupturing in transit. Drugs may be concealed within condoms, foil, latex, or cellophane. The average number of packets ingested may vary, but can be well over 100. Massive overdose will occur in individuals if any of these packets rupture, releasing a potential lethal dose of the drug. Body packers often ingest constipating agents such as Lamotil to hold back the intestinal contents during long flights or transport. In contrast, body stuffers generally have poorly wrapped drugs which are likely to be systematically absorbed, although in much less concentrated amounts than the body packer scenario. The physician should attempt to obtain any information regarding the amount of drug ingested and the type of packaging to predict the potential for toxicity. Plain abdominal radiographs are generally not useful for body stuffers, but may be positive for body packers. Gastrographing, swallow, or CT scan of the abdomen with contrast may reveal ingested packets in cases where plain radiographs are negative, but tend to be nonspecific and reader dependent. ED bedside ultrasonography would be a non-invasive method to rapidly assess for multiple drug packets, particularly in the gastric region. Radiographic appearance. Both plain films and ultrasound can be used for the assessment, but non-contrast CT of the abdomen is the most effective at detection. Epidemiology. There is a predilection for young males, with the average age being 30 years and 80% being male. Plain films may reveal smooth, well-circumscribed foreign bodies measuring approximately 2 to 3 centimeters, although may be variable in size and shape. With or without surrounding air rim or halo from air within the packets, the double condom signs, rosette sign, or air trap within the tied-off end, may be detected up to 75%, range 60 to 88% of packages. Use of foil wrap packages instead of condoms may increase false positive results. A CT scan may reveal smooth, well-circumscribed foreign bodies measuring approximately 2 to 3 centimeters, although also variable in size and shape, can accurately determine size, number, and location, and assess for complications. Reported house fields units density of various illicit drugs, for example, opium, cocaine, heroin, have different levels of density when looked at in CT scan. Non-contrast CT scan has a diagnostic accuracy of 97 to 100%. Clinical presentation. Patients may be brought in by law enforcement authorities for screening of suspected internal concealment of drugs. Most patients are asymptomatic but may present with symptoms of complications like perforation or obstruction, or drug intoxication, which may be intentional or unintentional. Body packers or stuffers with heroin or opioid-containing drugs may present with altered mental status, depressed respiratory drive, and myotic pupils. These patients may also require GI decontamination with whole bowel irrigation in order to enhance the elimination of drug packets. Treatment and prognosis. In body stuffers and packers, gastric lavage is ineffective and contraindicated as the procedure may cause rupture of the packets. Contraindications to whole bowel irrigation include unstable vital signs, respiratory compromise, and lack of bowel sounds or gut motility. Conservative therapy using polyethylene glycol or whole bowel irrigation is generally recommended in patients with potential toxicity. The most common product trade name, Go Lightly, is dosed at 1 to 2 liters per hour. It often requires NG tube administration unless the patient is cooperative. In patients who are extremely agitated, combative, or exhibit violent behavior, whole bowel irrigation should be withheld. Activated charcoal is given prior to whole bowel irrigation to absorb any leakage of the drugs from the package. Charcoal noted in the rectal effluent also helps indicate a completed round of whole bowel irrigation. It is important to ensure that all ingested packets are accounted for before the patient is discharged. After cleaning off the charcoal residue, turn any illegal contraband over to hospital security or the proper authorities. For obvious reasons, avoid pocketing the evidence. Patients in police custody are particularly high risk for subsequent morbidity due to a lack of reliable follow-up care or means of close observation and monitoring. Body packers with significant toxicity or evidence of bowel obstruction should have a surgical consultation. Laparotomy may be a necessary life-saving intervention to remove the leaking packages. For other educational videos like this video, please go to edexitvideo.com, a completely free patient education website.